Hey, welcome back to my new video. This is Sampath, you're watching Sampath Sound Effects channel. This is a CR Droid 7.7 based on Android 11 for Redmi Note 7 Pro. I mean the Violet, as you can see. This is the CR Droid version 7.7 with latest 5th June 2021 security patch. And this is the baseband version and the kernel version. As you can see, it's Excalibur Plus kernel used in this ROM. And this is the home screen and the app drawer, and this is the vanilla based ROM. If you want G apps variant also, I will be showing in the same video. As you can see, this is the dialer, and let me dial to 198. As you can see, the call recording feature is available. As you can see, if I press here, it will be recorded, and even speaker, everything is working fine. Call quality, network reception, everything is fine in this ROM, and messaging app. This is like CR Droid type, AOS speech type as of now, and this is the quick settings panel. If you want, you can add lots of toggles are available in the screen. As you can see, those things you can edit here. And coming to settings, is this the CR Droid settings, separate customization you will be getting here. As you can see, there are a lot of customization available in this ROM. Let me come with this miscellaneous one. Here you'll be getting the gaming mode. As you can see, that's how the gaming mode can be enabled. Let me enable dark mode from here. As you can see, the gaming mode here, you can block notifications, and let me adjust the brightness. This is the gaming mode. Here you get block notifications and all everything, and you can even enable the CPU information from here. Block notification on and off, and disable automatic brightness and ringer in gaming mode, and game mode instructions, dynamic mode. All these features are given in the application. You want to choose the game that you can select here, and smart charging is also available, and pocket detection, screenshot quality you can adjust from this miscellaneous settings in the CR Droid settings, customization settings. Let me go again there. Status bar, quick settings, lock screen, notification button, user interface, and next, notification sound, sound settings. Lots of customization is available. As you can see, you can enable or disable the charging sounds, and even select the vibrate on or off, and even the screenshot sound, and this volume steps and volume panel sound. All can be customized in this ROM. The customization king this ROM is. And tick notifications. Here you can customize four stop button, notification, background opacity, vibrate on connect call, vibrating, vibrate on disconnect. All the different settings are available in the notifications CR Droid settings. Now coming to user interface, you get ambient display here. If you want, you can enable. I recommend not to use it, but anyhow, if you want to see the notification, you need to enable. And cutout style, you will get this type of settings, and preference which style also given in this ROM. As you can see, default type and one UI type. I have made this navigation bar. As you can see, navigation bar style also, there are 5 presets are given, and this the quick settings tile style from default to many are given. Even the screen of animation settings, everything is given, weather settings. And coming to buttons, you get screenshot, airplane mode, emergency, advanced restart button, and secured lock screen. Those things are available in this ROM. End call, long press, power button, screenshot delay, wake device. And now coming to navigations, as you can see here, you get this and system gestures, quick open camera, double tap, and prevent ringing. Those two settings are given, gesture options, and this the lock screen settings. Lots of settings are available, you can read here, and you can adjust the quick settings, columns, rows, and even the row landscape and tile title, vibrate on tile, and quick settings tile icon color. All things are customized here. Even the battery percentage icon and battery icon and battery hide or not, and these settings are also given in this ROM. And status bar items are also given. As you can see, you can enable or disable here the quick settings, and even the clock style, left, right, or middle, and or hide, and old styles icon, 4G icon, battery style, again same things are given in the status bar. See Android settings also, as you can see. Then enter traffic monitor, battery bar, all the settings are given. And coming to display settings, as you can see, I'm in the violet parts. Here you can calibrate the display color calibration, even the thermal profiles are given. And coming to clear speaker is given, Mi sound enhancer, select the headphone type, those things are also given. And even choosing a preset is also given in this ROM. This comes in violet parts. Coming to battery, one of the best ROM I have used so far for this violet, I mean the Redmi Note 7 Pro, is the this ROM, SearDroid. As you can see, last full charge was almost a day ago. The ideal battery drain is very very low or negligible in this ROM. And coming to dark theme, as you can see, these presets are given, and style and wallpapers, you get this customization, grid type style and all. And this is the quick settings panel. Let me turn on the Wi-Fi and show you the internet speeds. I have here like 100 Mbps plan in Wi-Fi connection. I also show with the SIM network also. And if you are liking the video, give it a like, guys. And let me show you the mobile internet connection. It will pull up to 5 to 10 Mbps based on the network. As you can see, it's up to pulling up to 3, 4, sometimes even 5, or maximum you'll get 8 to 10 Mbps using the Jio SIM network. Do comment down below how is your network connection in your respected areas. And mostly I use with Wi-Fi, but to test I use with this network also. It's fine, call quality, everything is fine, no problem in this ROM. And all the quick settings toggles also working fine. And coming to screen recording, you get record, audio, show touches on screen, show stop dot, long press to move it, and lower quality video. These options are given. This is the home settings. You get this pre-installed wallpapers, some are here. It's fine. This is how the ROM is. And this is the vanilla OS type. If you want G apps type, you need to flash the flame apps. And this is the inbuilt camera, Snapdragon camera you get. Let me go to here. It's a basic camera. If you want, you can use build G cam or even NG cam, anything G cam ports you can use. And let me show you the file manager in this ROM. This is how the pre-installed apps you get. As you can see, on the calculator is also available. This is how the ROM is. I will go to here. Let me show you the volume panel here. As you can see, it's new Android 11 tile type. If you want, you can change that also. And let me restart here and go into recovery. And as you can see, this is how you need to flash firmware first, next the ROM, next the Flame G apps. If you want G apps version, if you want vanilla one, you can directly flash that. And if you want to root the smartphone, you can flash Magisk and later fcrypt file, I mean the ftcrypt file. After four things, it will be like this. And if you are first time to this channel, hit that subscribe button and allow the notification to get this kind of videos first to you. And share among the Note 7 Pro users, and I will be making similar kind of videos, also tech related videos. Do comment down below how is the video, and what is your daily driver ROM. Do comment down below, and what kind of videos you will need to see regarding this Note 7 Pro or the Violet. Do comment down below, and if you like the video, give it a like. As you can see, this is how the flashing method is. It's easy. In a similar way, any ROM can be flashed, I mean this AOSP. If it is MIUI version, it will be different. Let me reboot this. After flashing four different files, it will be rebooted. And this is how the booting animation you get for this SearDroid 7.7 on Redmi Note 7 Pro with 111 June security patch, latest July build for this Note 7 Pro device. As you can see, this is the SierDroid booting animation logo. It takes a little bit of time when you flash for the first time. Later on, it takes like around less than 1 minute, but for the first time, it takes time. As you can see, it booted into SierDroid ROM. I will finish the settings and I will come back. And this is the Geekbench scores you get in this ROM. As you can see, single score 496 and multi score 1343. It's a good ROM. You can use it as a daily driver and also for gaming is also good. But better thing is the battery life, and this is the audio FX feature you get in this ROM. You can amplify your speakers, even the headphones. I am using wired headphones and even the Bluetooth earphones. Everything is working fine in this ROM. No problem in that. And this is how the, and coming to fingerprint scanner, as you can see, it's working fine, no problem. Even the face unlock option is also given. I'm showing here the fingerprint scanner, it's working fine, no problem. And this is how the lock screen you get. And charging speeds are also normal considering 10 watt charger. And this is the CPU-Z application. It shows this set system with 675 Snapdragon. The performance is also good, and this all the sensors, nothing is missed after the ROM changing this ROM. And coming to camera to API, it's also enabled. You can use any Gcam ports in this ROM. And coming to safety net status, it's also get passed. Everything is fine in this ROM. You can definitely try it out for better battery life. I have experienced very good battery life in this ROM rather than very good performance. Yes, it has very good performance, but still the battery life is very, very good. And there's the digital well-being and parental control. And good thing is you even get the software updates for this ROM. As you can see, you'll be getting the update. You need to dirty flash, or you can directly go through here update wrap. And this is the SierDroid 7.7 on Redmi Note 7 Pro.